Welcome to episode 5 of Research Without Tears. This is possibly the episode that's most important, so don't blow this off. You have to pay attention. This is how to keep track of your evidence as you collect it. And if I could point to one of these episodes that will have the most impact on your final grade, it may be this one. Students who are well organized and who organize in this way almost always find that the research paper is a lot easier and they usually get a better grade. So this one's important, so listen up. So I'm suggesting that before you do anything else, before you eat dinner, before you go to bed tonight, before you text your friends, you run to the store and you buy a bunch of 3x5 or 4x6 note cards. You're going to use these note cards in two ways, and if you don't have them, disorganization will threaten to overwhelm you. And I've seen this happen many, many times, so the note cards are really a good idea. You're going to use the cards first for works cited information, and secondly, you're going to use the cards for content that you come across. So let's talk about each of those in turn. Let's talk first about the works cited cards. On the works cited cards, every time you find a source that you think you might use, you don't have to commit to it, it's a might use, you want to write down on that card everything that you'll need on your works cited page. You want to put it in MLA format, and you have some good formatting information about how to do that. You only want one source per card, and you want, this one's kind of important if you have messy handwriting, you want to print it or write it carefully, because if you're squinting at it at, you know, 2 in the morning, 3 weeks from now, you have to be able to read it and you have to be able to get it right, because I go back and I recheck your works cited list, so everything on it has to be accurate. So make sure that you take a little time to write all that in a way that you can read that's neat and clear. So those are your works cited cards. Then you can put them in one pile. In fact, it's great if they're a different size or a different color from the much more numerous content cards that you're also going to be creating. So on your content cards, you're essentially taking notes as you read from your sources, some of which may not leave the library, or maybe you're finding them in a book or online or whatever. But there are three ways that you can record content on those content cards. First, direct quotes. Direct quotes are word for word whatever you found in your source. Word for word, letter for letter, punctuation mark for punctuation mark, and they have quotes around them. They might be short, they might be long, but you want to put somewhere on your card quotation marks so that you can always remember, okay, this one was a direct quote. So you need to code that on all of the cards that are direct quotes. A second kind of content card would be your paraphrase cards. This is your rewording of whatever your scholarly source said so that you're not using their words or their syntax. You're putting it into your own language for the most part. So when you do a paraphrase card, you might want to write PP for paraphrase on the card to remind yourself this isn't a direct quote, this is just a paraphrase. And then the third kind of content card would be a summary card. This is if you have a whole page of information that proves one point, and all you really need to do in your paper is prove that one point, you can just put a summary saying, you know, this whole page proved this one point, and then be sure that you include the page or the pages where you got that summary information, because you'll still need to put all of that on your works cited page. So you may have direct quotes, you may have paraphrases, and you may have summaries, but all of that's valuable information for your content cards. So then when you're ready to start thinking about your outline and how to organize your paper, you're going to take those content cards and you're going to organize them by topic, using my outline that I always give you on my assignment sheet for the three pieces that I want in your paper or the five things that I want to make sure that you cover. You're going to kind of divide your note cards into the pieces that I've given you by topic, and then you can just tell by looking at how tall each stack of cards is whether you have enough data for each of the topics or whether you're going to need to go out and do more research. You'll be able to check just by looking at your cards. once you've kind of figured out how much you have and where each card is going to fit in which pile, you can mark each note card by the topic, say that this is, you know, your early period, or say that this is your conclusion, and then by subtopic, so that you're already starting to organize your paper by organizing your cards. You're going to organize the whole set of content cards according to the questions that they're answering, and within the question that they're answering by topic and subtopic, and you'll be so far ahead in terms of organizing your paper and also seeing what your research gaps are that you're almost certain to get an A on the paper. Oh, I didn't say that. Forget that. You'll do a good job, and hopefully you'll do well.